PSA Collector.
What's going on, guys? It's Matt with PSAcollector.com back with another video. And today, guys, I'm trying something new. I'm creating a top 10 basketball cards that I'm buying now before the playoffs begin, okay? So everything's up in the air right now. There's so many options, and I wanted to create a list of 10 players that I'm buying now and kind of show you guys my strategy and my perspective, okay? So, guys, before we jump into this list, I cannot stress enough, do your own research, okay? Do the due diligence before you start buying up cards. I don't want you buying cards of players that you don't like. If you don't like these players, then don't buy the cards. If you don't like watching the players, if you're not fans of the players, then don't buy the cards. Do your own research and assessment and go from there. I'm just letting you guys know what I'm doing and what I'm buying and my thought process, okay? So, I'm going to be making this a premiere. I'm going to be in the chats. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Let me know what cards you're picking up. Without any further ado, guys, let's jump into this top 10 list. Starting off the list at number 10, Russell Westbrook, guys. Come on. Look at his stats. He's a 9-time All-Star, 2-time scoring champ, 8-time All-NBA, 2-time All-Star MVP, 2016 MVP. He's a 2-time assist champ. He's 6'3", 200-pound point guard for the Houston Rockets. He just moved there. He rejoined his previous teammate, James Harden. They both played at OKC together. So they have a little bit of chemistry. They know how to play together. It's still unsure how that chemistry is going to play out at the Rockets. But I think there's some big potential for Russell Westbrook, guys. He's a workhorse, guys. Russell Westbrook, when he's on the court, he is going full steam, full speed ahead, okay? Both defense and offense. He doesn't really have a terrific three-point shot. However, guys, he makes that up in the rebounds, the assists, and the points. Regardless, he is an incredible point guard in the league. I think he's definitely going to be Hall of Fame material. Some of his rookie cards are pretty expensive. However, guys, his 2008 Bowman base paper card, rookie card, is pretty dirt cheap right now. I think they're selling for like $10 to $15 on average. That's a great pickup for Russell Westbrook cards. If you see some other ones ending for dirt cheap, definitely a great pickup. Russell Westbrook, guys, very underrated player, and he is a tremendous, tremendous basketball player. A lot of guys in the league say the same thing. They fear playing Westbrook just because he's so hard. He plays so hard and he's so hungry. So, number 10, Russell Westbrook. Number nine, Giannis Antetokounmpo second year cards, guys. I've been screaming this for a while. His rookie cards have gone up. I've been picking up his second year select cards. His second year, maybe even his hoops, but guys, his rookie hoops is at raw and ungraded is like $150. It's insane. So if you can't afford the rookie cards, go ahead and pick up the second year cards. He's a 4-time All-Star, 3-time All-NBA. He's a 2018 MVP. He is averaging right now 29 points per game, 13.7 rebounds. We all know Giannis cards are going to go up, and they're not going to go down anytime soon, guys. Right now, the Bucks are first in the conference, Eastern Conference. I mean, his cards are only going to go up. If you can't afford his rookie cards, look for his second year cards. I chose the 2014 Select. I think those are very cheap right now. If you look at what they were selling for a couple months ago to what they are now, they've gone up significantly. So I've been buying the 2014 Giannis Antetokounmpo select cards, or his hoops cards even. I think they're really dirt cheap right now. Look for the short prints, look for the hollows, the silver prisms, look for the parallels, okay? The cards with a shorter print run, and you can't go wrong. His rookie cards are getting out of reach for most of us, so next best thing, guys, second year cards. Giannis, you can't go wrong with him. He's a superstar. He's only improving. He's only getting better and better. He plays the full court, offense and defense. So like I said, guys, Giannis, second year cards. Number eight, Anthony Davis, second year cards. Anthony Davis, guys, he's a 6'10", 253-pound power forward, plays with the Lakers, he plays with LeBron. He is a 7-time All-Star, 3-time block champ, 3-time All-Defense player, 3-time All-NBA, 2016 All-Star MVP. He is booming. He's developing. He is incredible right now. Anthony Davis is so undervalued. His rookie cards have been picking up slowly, pretty steadily, actually. So I've been looking at the second year Anthony Davis cards. His rookie was in 2012, so I've been picking up the 2013 Select. 2013 hoops even. I definitely see Anthony Davis and LeBron winning a championship or two. They are on fire. They have Kyle Kuzma right now. He's developing as well. His rookie card's another card to look out for. People see the potential in him. He's an offensive player and defensive. He plays both sides of the ball. He's up and down the court, and he makes it look so easy. Anthony Davis is a natural born basketball player, guys. Come on. He has a plus LeBron James is assisting to him left and right, and he's just flushing him. Anthony Davis, guys, he's been a back-to-back all-star player for the last 7 years, and he accomplished that playing on the with the Pelicans, New Orleans Pelicans. So he's been Anthony Davis has been doing double doubles for almost his entire career, okay, with rebounds and points. He's a 25 point per game on average, and 10 rebounds a game on average. So guys, check out Anthony Davis if you haven't looked into him already. The Brow, AD, Ant, Fat Man, Unibrow, whatever you want to call him, it's Anthony Davis, guys. He is a all-star, and in my opinion, he's Hall of Fame bound for sure. Number seven, Ben Simmons rookie cards. I know, guys, he has not made one three-point in his entire career in the NBA. However, what he lacks in his three-point, he gains in his rebounds, his assists, and his points even, okay? He's a two-time All-Star, and he has even completed one three-point basket. That's insane. He's 6'10", 230 pounds, point guard. He is showing a little, he's showing more and more an improvement. A lot of guys are hating on Ben Simmons because he doesn't have a jump shot. Which, guys, the game of the NBA is changing. Players are developing in certain ways that they weren't previously. He is a full court player, plays both sides of the ball, defense, offense. Ben Simmons is tricky. The reason I like him so much is because his cards are so cheap, okay? All it takes is a couple good games, a couple more good seasons, a couple more back-to-back All-Star seasons, and his cards are going to go up. But like I said, they are dirt cheap. Specifically, his 2016 Donruss Optic, guys, they're selling for pennies on the dollar right now. $5, I think I saw him selling for. Ben Simmons, highly undervalued, highly underrated. A lot of guys like him. Philadelphia fans like Ben Simmons. He has a mediocre work ethic. I think he definitely needs to improve on that. However, simply because the price of his cards are so low, I think that if you go pick up a couple now, in a year or two, you could see, you know, potential, especially if the 76ers make it far in the playoffs this year. His cards will for sure go up. So I think if you're looking for a cheap, low-risk investment, Ben Simmons cards are the way to go. If watch some hype videos on him, do your own research, make sure you like the player, make sure you like his play style. But like I said, it's very unique. He has yet to complete a three-point shot in his NBA career, which is very bizarre to me that he's been a two-time All-Star and has not made a three-point shot. He's not like a perimeter player. He just piles through the paint and gets to the basket. He's very tricky player to evaluate. But like I said, he offers a new kind of play style to the NBA simply because he has no jump shot whatsoever. However, he's still dominating. Assists, steals, blocks are okay. His points are okay. If he starts developing a jump shot, guys, his cards can go through the roof. But that takes a while, so we'll see. Number six. LeBron James second year cards. All right, guys, we all know LeBron James is our generation GOAT, right? His rookie cards have gone to the roof. However, his second year cards, guys, still affordable, okay? And when you have a player like LeBron James who's talked about a GOAT status, his second year cards are going to go up, okay? His rookie cards have gone past the point of no return for a lot of us collectors. So the next best thing are his second year cards, specifically his Tops, his Base Bowman, and even the Chrome cards. The Chrome cards are still, if you pay attention and you're patient, you can snag them at a good price. Under $60, maybe under $50. But I would suggest if you're on a budget, look for the Base Tops and the Base Bowman cards. There are a plethora of second year LeBron James that you can go at different angles. Now's the chance to get those cards. If the Lakers win the championship this year, you can bet your bottom dollar that his cards are going to have another huge spike. Okay, so pick up those second year cards now, LeBron James. And if you see his rookie cards, get those. If you have a higher budget, go for the rookie cards first. Number five, Luka Doncic rookie cards and second year cards. Okay, guys, Luka Doncic, he has been blowing the league away with his performance on the court. Luka is statistically the best rookie of his 2018 class. It's between him and Trae Young, points and assists. It's between Luka and Trae. However, Trae is with the Hawks. He's not making it to the playoffs this year. Luka is. So look at for his 2018 Panini Select rookie card, the Concourse or the Premier. Those are really cheap right now, under roughly $60 to $50 a piece, raw and ungraded. And the PSA 9 cards are under $100. Still cheap and affordable and a great investment. Check out the population reports on those cards, guys. Much lower than Prism, much lower than Donruss, Panini Donruss Optic. So if you want to go for the second year cards, go for the Prisms, the Select, the tricolors, or the base, the silver prism, concourse, the premier, or even the courtside, guys. Definitely a good investment with those cards, because collectors are going to want the silver prism second year Lukas and the hollows, the Donruss Optic, the Blue Velocity, all kinds of options, of very affordable options as well. Second year Luka cards. I chose to go ahead and look at the 2018 Select Luka Doncic rookie, because I think that is highly, highly undervalued right now in the marketplace. It's comparable to the Optic. However, the Optic print run was much higher than the Select. A lot of you guys know what I'm talking about. So go with the Select rookie cards first, and then do the Optic if you can afford the Optic. If you can't, if that's out of your budget, absolutely second year Prism silver and hollow cards. Don't really go towards the base. However, if your budget doesn't allow you to go for the more expensive stuff, then yeah, absolutely go for the base. Look for the short prints, the super short prints, the courtside, or the parallels, the serial number cards. Go for those first and then go to the base. I still think those base cards are a great pickup. Look at the LeBron James second year cards. You guys, a lot of you guys underestimate the power of the second year cards. Now that is with the prediction of Luka playing like he's playing now for the remainder of his career. If he doesn't, if something happens, then those second year cards could take a dip. So that's why I say try to get the rookies first, and if they're out of your budget, go for the second year cards. Luka Doncic, guys, you can't go wrong with any of his cards, in my opinion. I want to collect them all, so check them out, guys. Number four. Donovan Mitchell rookie cards. Donovan Mitchell, guys, in the 2017 rookie class, Donovan Mitchell across the board, statistically the best player so far. Check it out on basketballreference.com. With his performance and the price of his cards, great pickup. They're slowly rising in value. People are catching on. So go for the parallels first, guys, on the rookie cards. If you can afford them, if you can't, then absolutely pick up the base. But Donovan Mitchell, his cards for sure have potential to go up. If he continues to play like he's playing, people are going to catch on. If the Jazz advance in the playoffs this coming month, for sure his cards are going to get a spike. They've already seen an uptick. So pick some up while you can, guys. Donovan Mitchell, rookie cards, 2017. A lot of the Select cards are undervalued as well. Number three, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander rookie card. Another 2018 rookie, plays for the OKC Thunder, Western Conference. Right now they're fifth. He's 6'5" point guard, guys. He is showing massive improvement. And in just the 1 year he's been playing, dominant player. He's fearless. He does offense, he does defense. He's a great rebounder. He has a 7-foot wingspan. He steals the ball. He's like a, you know, He drives through the paint like a slithering snake, very unpredictable. He's very versatile. I've been watching a lot of SGA videos, hype videos, and I'm like, wow, this kid can play. He is going to be an all-star player. OKC, Thunder, they've developed a lot of strong players in the NBA, James Harden and Russell Westbrook. I see SGA being a leader on that team, the go-to guy. He has a great work ethic. He's a positive player. He's young, and his cards are dirt cheap right now. In my opinion, they're dirt cheap. So lots of upside to SGA's rookie cards. Like I said, they're fifth in the Western Conference. They're definitely going to be making it to the playoffs. If they advance, his cards definitely, without a doubt, will get a spike. So I've been picking up a lot of his cards, low-key. Rookie cards, and just, you know, gonna sit on him for a while. And it's a player that I like watching, so it makes it more fun when you mesh your investment with your passion for the hobby, and you become a fan of the player. So like I said, watch videos and do your own research, guys, before you start buying these cards. Don't just take my word for it. Invest in players that you like watching. Okay, so number three, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander 2018 rookie cards.
Number two,
Jason Tatum rookie cards, guys. Come on. Boston Celtics. He's a 6'8" power forward. He's been developing and blossoming for the past 3 years. A lot of people underestimated him, including myself, the first 2 years. However, this year, he's been playing very impressively, getting a lot of attention from the media. He averaged 23.6 points per game, 7.1 rebounds, and 2.9 assists. Not so great in assists, however, he's a pretty good defensive player. Rebounding, he has a pretty good block per game, and steals. He has 1.4 steals per game. So Jason Tatum is a great defensive player. He's a great offensive player. 23.6 points per game, guys. Jason Tatum cards, they were dirt cheap, guys. They were incredibly dirt cheap, and I'm kicking myself for not picking them up early, because they've tripled in value essentially across the board. Tatum rookies, people are seeing the potential in Tatum and playing for the Boston Celtics, one of the biggest NBA organizations of all time. The fan base, guys, people are going to want his cards. The value is going to shoot through the roof if the Celtics advance in the playoffs. I can just see him being an all-star player for the remainder of his career. Jason Tatum, a lot of you guys already know, a lot of you have been hearing about Tatum. So I put him second on the list because his cards, guys, are still affordable. Okay, his rookie cards are still affordable. However, with his performance and his hype, it's almost to the point where I'm looking for the second year cards, because his cards have gotten pretty expensive. So pick up the Optic, pick up the Select. The Select are highly underrated right now, undervalued. So look for the Select first, just the base cards, guys, the base cards. Get those up while you can, all right?
Number one,
Pascal Siakam rookie cards. That's right, guys, Pascal Siakam, 6'9", power forward for the Raptors. They're second in the Eastern Conference. Honestly, he's been flying under my radar for a while. I decided to finally look into him, and I watched him play, and I was very impressed, guys. Defensively, offensively, he is like one of the most improved players over the last, since 2019, okay? So in 2018, 16.9 points per game. 2019, 23.6 points, okay? His steals, his assists, his rebounds, and his blocks. He's overall, guys, designed and molded to be an all-around great basketball player. Okay, you can't go wrong with the Pascal Siakam rookie cards simply because his cards are so cheap right now. Okay, he has a huge upside, huge potential for the Raptors. One of their 2018, he already has a championship under his stats. Okay, so 2018 championship team. They were already a great team. He's a great player, and he makes that team even better, okay? I'm not saying he's the best player on this list. I'm just saying Pascal Siakam rookie cards are so cheap, and with the performance that he's had this year, 2019, if that continues and he continues to throw stats down and be an all-star, then absolutely his cards are going to triple and double and triple and quadruple, just like Tatum cards did and, Luka cards did. So, guys, number one on my list, Pascal Siakam, 2016, Optic or Select, or hoops even. I've been picking them up all up because it's like picking up, you know, literally fruit off of the ground. They're cheap. They're so cheap. I've been looking at Pascal Siakam for a while. I think he's honestly the most underrated, undervalued player and with the most upside right now, okay? Are the Raptors going to make it to the finals? Are they going to make it and win it all this year? I don't know. It's tough to say, guys. There's so many good players, so many good teams that they're going to have to go through. And it's all up in the air. We've had this shutdown, this lockdown. The players have been resting. So it's just a tough call. But my number one pick, guys, Pascal Siakam. Look at his stuff. Check him out before you invest in him. Do your research first. If you like watching him, if you're a fan of the player, then go ahead and pull the trigger, especially when the cards are so cheap. I like to do that. I like to buy the cheap stuff first. So, and then sell later. So buy low, sell high, guys. All right, guys, there you go. That's the list. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for liking the video. Thanks for subscribing. And guys, I'm releasing these videos one day in advance for my members to watch. So if you want to join my membership, be part of Team PSA Collector, hit that join button down below. Help support me, support my channel, and be a part of Team PSA Collector, guys. So it's $1.99 a month. It a little bit goes a long way. I wanted to make that an option for you guys out there. So thank you all. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. All right.